Senator Chris Dodd will be unveiling the details of his plan to rewrite the rules of Wall Street at 2 p.m. today. Now, the Fed is bound to see the biggest changes under the proposed legislation, but does it adequately address the main gaps in current regulatory rules? David Nasens, a managing director at Promontory Financial. He was a principal advisor to Treasury Secretary Hank Paulson and was one of the authors of the Bush administration's regulatory reform plan. He joins us live from Washington this morning. Thanks so much for coming on and joining us, David. You know, we're still just getting details. We'll get the specifics at 2 p.m. from Senator Dodd himself. But from what we know at this point, does the existing proposal really prevent another crisis from happening?
Well, the existing proposal does two things that are really important. The first is that it covers something called systemic risk. It creates a new council to address system-wide risk, which is something the regulatory structure didn't have in the first place. The second is it calls for something called enhanced resolution authority, which basically gives the government some money to deal with a situation so as to prevent another Lehman Brothers situation. So those are two good things in the bill that is necessary after the current crisis.
Mm-hmm. What's not in there? I mean, we've got a lot of proposals in here. As you ran through some of them yourself, but also the bill will give the power to crack down on risky practices or certain types of lendings by banks, also give the government power to dismantle failing financial firms. Nothing in here, though, so far that we can see on the ratings agencies themselves or specifically on credit default swaps. Is there more that should be in here or should there be less?
Well, there's a couple of things that aren't in there. The system is still going to be hopelessly complicated with a lot of different agencies, and that's something I wish we saw a little bit more rationalization of. There's not going to be too much difference on credit rating agencies. I think they're going to punt to the SEC to do a lot of that. There will be some regulation of over-the-counter derivatives, and that may take up some of the CDS-type issues that you mentioned. But and there's obviously nothing with the GSEs, Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, and that's pretty much a big hole. For something as big and complicated as regulatory restructuring revamp.
Mm-hmm. Now, you point out in your notes here that wind-down fund that for failing financial firms, that $50 billion fund, has a fee issue that you find particularly interesting. Explain what you're focused on here.
Sure. Well, the creation of a systemic dissolution fund is in order to give the government some money to pay for the winding down of a firm. The original Dodd proposal had this paid for after a crisis occurs, so you could decide, you know, who really was the cause of the crisis, and then you assess fees against those funds. What the new bill likely will have is imposing these fees up front. So it'll be very, very difficult to decide who should pay, how much they should pay, and whether or not it's going to be fair, because you're going to have different types of firms all being assessed different rates for activities that they may not be, that may not cause the systemic risk.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be pretty complicated.
It's going to be an out-of-pocket fee, essentially, for the banks.
It's going to be an upfront fee, which is, if passed, will be something that there'll be an enormous amount of debate, and it'll be pretty controversial.
Now, the Consumer Protection Agency is the thing that's sort of drawn the most attention as to the controversy surrounding here. I mean, is it going to make it through Congress? What's your thought here?
Well, it's pretty interesting. I mean, first of all, the people were criticizing the Federal Reserve and their role in consumer protection, and now the Fed gets that authority. So I'm not sure who's happy by putting it at the Fed, because the people who didn't think the Fed did a good role, a lot of the folks in the consumer advocacy function, they're not going to be happy there. And the folks that at the Fed that feel as if they didn't get enough standing to do consumer protection may be upset as well. So I'm not sure who that makes happy, to be quite honest with you. It's really one of those compromise deals that people are going to scratch their head and figure out, why did that occur?